Hi beauties, welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing a Get Ready With Me featuring the Melissa Michelle and Ulta palette. I am so happy to get this palette. Like, as soon as she announced that she was coming out with the palette and I saw it on her Snapchat, I needed it. So first off, I want to say huge congrats to Melissa. If you guys aren't following her already, head over to her channel and subscribe. She's amazing. I've been following her since she was filming in her closet days, so it's been a while. So in this video, I do a Get Ready With Me using this palette only, and I show you swatches and I give you my thoughts. So if you would like to know what I think about this palette, then keep on watching. Okay, so I've already primed my eyes and applied powder just to get rid of the stickiness. I'm gonna go in with Alana right there. Here is a swatch. Ooh-hoo-hoo. Going in with my fluffy brush, I'm just gonna apply Alana on the inner, outer corners and into the crease. I'm feeling a halo eye today. Super pigmented. Actually way more pigmented than I thought it would be on the eye. It's a very unique color. It's like a deep plum, but it has like brighter purple shimmer depending on what direction the light is hitting it. Okay, I need to blend out this because it looks like I just got punched really good in the eye. For that, I'm going in with Rosemary using the same brush. A swatch of Rosemary. It's a really nice transition shade. And I'm just gonna put that in the crease. These shadows blend out really well, and they're very soft and really pigmented so far. Wow, super, super easy to blend. For a little bit more blending in the crease, I'm gonna go in with Tobo. Here's a swatch of Tobo. It's a really nice light taupey color, matte. And with the same brush, I'm just gonna go right on the edges. I really want this to be seamless, and it's really blending out really, really easily with minimal effort, so I really do like that. Okay, for the fun part that I'm really looking forward to doing, I'm gonna go in with Teresita, I believe that's how you say it. Here is a swatch. Oh my god. Oh, it's so pretty. In her demo video, she recommended that you use your fingers for the chunkier, glittery shadow, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just going to apply a Teresita in the middle of my lid where I left that space, and as you can see, oh my god, it's more beautiful than I thought. It's literally like liquid gold. That's the best way I can describe this color. And it's going on there really, really nicely with just my finger. One layer. I only dipped my finger in it once and did that, and that was the payoff. Wow. She also mentioned that you could use those sponge applicators that you get in palettes. They work really well for the glitter shadows. In love. Completely in love. I don't know if you guys can see right there. A little bit of fallout, and she did mention that the glittery shadows would have a little bit of fallout, but it's not too bad. It's not a problem since I didn't do my face yet. Now I'm just blending that inner and outer corner into the gold, so that way it's no harsh lines in between. I'm actually going to apply a little bit more of Alana, that deep dark purple that I use, just the tiniest bit with a more smaller brush, just so I have a little bit more control. One more blending for good measure. For the brow bone, I'm going in with Wheezy. It's a really nice matte cream color. And I'm just applying that on my brow bone. Okay, for a little bit of warmth, I'm gonna do something a little bit daring. I'm gonna go in with Bing Bing. I'm gonna swatch Bing Bing. Ooh, it's a nice like brick orangey red matte color. I'm taking the tiniest amount on my brush. I only dipped in once. I'm just gonna apply that in the crease. Yes! Okay, that's what I was missing. I was missing something, I wasn't sure. It just added a nice little warmth to the eye, and she did mention that in her tutorial, and she was right. All right, I'm gonna pop on my lashes, do majority of my face, and come back to finish up on the eyes and face. All right, brows are on, rest of the face is on, time to finish up the eyes. From an inner corner, I'm so excited to go in with Lola. Let's see. Ooh. Oh. Yeah, let's just go. Just going to put that in the inner corner. Mm-hmm. Yep. That, I need this in my life. I'm gonna be using this as an inner corner forever and ever. This is like the perfect shade. Don't kill me when I say this, but it reminds me a lot of Champagne Pop by Jaclyn Hill and Becca. Oh, I can't believe I just said that. Oh, everyone's gonna come and kill me now. Oh no, what have I done? Oh great. I've only swatched Champagne Pop once in Sephora, but this reminds me of the swatch a lot. For those of you that own Champagne Pop, let me know if Lola is pretty similar to it. But that's really pretty, I like it a lot. Even though Lola was the same formulation as the gold on my lid, there was no fallout. So just to make a note of that. I'm gonna go back in with Alana and just apply that on the outer and inner corners. Same pattern as my lid. And for the middle, I'm gonna do that gold shade. I'm really scared because I'm already seeing fallout a little. I know it's nowhere near as vibrant with the brush, and she pointed that out in her video, but I don't want it to be super harsh on the lower lash line anyway. I still got a little bit of fallout, but not too bad because I pressed it on with the brush. I'm sure if you wet that shade, it would be minimal to no fallout. And before I finish up, I do want to swatch the colors that I didn't use, just so you can get the feel for the whole palette. Cade's and Harley right here were the only two I didn't use, so I'm going to swatch them. Here's Cade's. Really nice shimmery copper. And here's Harley. Harley definitely comes up way lighter than in the pan. But still a nice brown. It's a nice neutral brown, not too warm, not too cool. So these are the finished eyes. Alright, for blush, I'm going in with Mahal. It's a really nice brown tone, rosy, dusty color. She said that this worked for all skin tones, so we're gonna find out. It is a nice color. That's a nice everyday color. I'm not mad about it at all. And it's really buildable, which is a good thing. I kind of like when blushes aren't too pigmented, so that way you can build them up without having to try and take away color. I like it. It's a nice, like, everyday color. It's not too pigmented, but you can definitely build it up. Here's a swatch of it. See, it's just really nice neutral color. Can't you tell how breathy I am with makeup since I haven't done a full face in a while? Look at that. Like, what did I do? I don't know, guys. Now for the highlight. I'm excited about this. So this is Holler right here. It's three colors. It's, I think, like a pink tone, gold, and a bronze. You can use them separately or you can swirl them together, but I'm gonna swatch them separately and then swatch them together and then apply it all together on my cheeks. That's the pink toned. That's the gold toned. This is the bronze toned. Really, really pretty. And this is them all together. Whoa! Oh my god. Screw doing it separately, just do it all together. Wow, do you see that? I only swirled my finger around it like two or three times. That's it. That's it. Let's put it on. Let's see. Oh. Oh my gosh. Listen. This is as pigmented as the glow kits from Anastasia. No joke. I have one so I can compare. Whoa! Wow, I'm gonna have to actually tone that down because it's that crazy. Oh my gosh. Ooh! Doesn't look that good because I have a lot of breakouts in that part of my face, but still. That payoff. Wow, I'm impressed. I'm really impressed. Just gotta tone that down a little though. I don't want to blind anyone today. It's a little bit. Highlight, A+. I like it a lot. I'll be using it more. Finally, I will be using the liquid lipstick in the color Scandi. It's on the bottom. Really nice color. It basically matches the blush. Let's apply it. Smells like cupcakes too, which is a plus. Really nice color. I like it a lot. Like, a lot. It's a really nice everyday color. Keep in mind, I think it's supposed to dry down all the way matte, but it's not for me because I had on Vaseline lip balm before. I always do that with like the lipsticks because they just always feel too drying for me. But it's definitely a little sticky, and she did say that. But it's not too uncomfortable. I really love the color. Like, I really love the color. I needed a color like this for a long time. But it was really easy to put on. There was no lip liner needed, but she did say if you use different types of lip liners that it will change the color, so that's pretty cool. So my overall final thoughts, I love this palette. I had a feeling I would love it like this just by looking at it, but now it's in my hands and I tried it out for you all. I'm in love, especially this liquid lipstick. This is the perfect shade for every day. And it looks different on different skin tones. She did say that, so keep that in mind. But on my skin tone, girl, I could wear this every day with any look and it'll look good. I give this palette 2 thumbs up. I really do enjoy it and I'll be using it a lot more. Let me know if you would like to see me do different looks using different colors. Anyway, I hope you guys have fun watching me and getting ready with me. Once again, a huge, huge congrats to Melissa on this palette. Girl, you did amazing. It's bomb. I love it. Thank you guys for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!